are very important before a board exam. And that is possible to score more than 90% mark even if you try in the last 10 days using the techniques that I am going to tell you. My name is Kalyan and I am working with many students and many principals and other teachers on how to improve on the productivity apart from the strategist. Let us go straight into the point. When the board exams comes, the students are not very clear. Till now they would not be having, either they are not at all serious or they are too serious about their marks. It all depends on how their parents and how their teachers pushes them hard. In both scenarios it is not good, and especially when they reach the point of the zenith of bursting. So that is where many students get affected. Even still, I remember one of my friend when I was studying in school. He was a brilliant student. He was an extraordinary brilliant student. And what happened is his uncle or somebody, who just blasted him, he scolded him one day before the exams because he went and played cricket or something outside, and that guy scolded him. You know what happened? Immediately came back and around 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock in the night, without telling anybody, he just moved out of the house. He just left the house because he felt really inferior. He felt really humiliated, or he got into the fear factor of maybe losing the exam or maybe losing the confidence or whatever it is. So these last 10 days are very, very important. So let us just see how that can be sorted out and how students can bring more marks, more accolades, and they can make their parents also proud. So let us go to that now. As you see now, the most important point thing is that when you are studying, the last 10 days, what you can do is maybe some good students, some brilliant students, they have already done it from the beginning. But if you are lagging behind, what you can do is you can just take different color sticky notes. Take different color sticky notes, and wherever you find very important points, note it down. Note it down, and that will be easy for you to understand things. It will be easy for you, even if you want to go back and if you want to just check it out how it is running out, it will be easy for you to capture it back. So here what you can do is you can put that sticky note, and if necessary you can have some memory code written into that sticky note, and that memory code can be written into a rough note or a rough book or pocket notebook or whatever it is. So you can correlate between that memory code, the color code of the sticky note, and this one. So that is one of the most important thing that you can do always. And once you do that, what happens is the students will be in the position to easily correlate between the questions and the chapters which are very important for them. The second one is, what happens is one big mistake what parents do is maybe the student or the boy or the girl is used to study in the night. Maybe they used to study till 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock and go for late night sleeps and all those things. Suddenly what happens is parents says, no, waking up late, studying till night, late night and waking up late in the morning is not good. You will not be able to, you will not be in a position to remember things, the memory will be affected, all those things. So what happens is he or she will be forced to change the way of studies. He will be forced to change the timing. As you know, there is a inner clock inside every one of us. The student would have already got accustomed to that inner clock where he will be or she will be comfortable studying late night. They will not be feeling sleepy or whatever it is. So suddenly one fine day, what you are doing is you are asking them to change their timetable, change their scenario, and they are asked to study, wake up early in the morning and start studying. ultimately what happens is there is only 10 days left, and what happens is neither they will be in a position to sleep early in the night because they are used to late night studies, nor they will be in a position to wake up early in the morning. So precious days are gone. So never post any kind of unwarranted changes during the last 10 days of the exam, last 10 days before the exams. And third point is, there are many, many parents who say, sit and study, don't do anything, don't go out, don't do that, don't do this, don't take this, don't watch TV. No, don't, please, for God's sake, don't push them hard like this. As the research states, it is not really possible for any person to concentrate on a particular thing for more than 15 minutes. 15, I'm not 50 actually, I'm saying 15 minutes. After 15 minutes, they need a break of at least 1 or 2 minutes. So let them take a break after the 15 minutes and let them use it. I mean, what they can do. I have seen one girl who has scored very good marks. What she used to do is, she will be studying for 15 minutes, and what she do is she come and switch on the TV and watch it for 2 or 3 minutes or 5 minutes or whatever it is, and again she will go back to study. Like the people can also do yoga or something like that, and they can just simply close their eyes and sit and for 2-3 minutes and proceed. So this is very, very important from their point of view for better studies. The other one that I want to tell you is, avoid the, even if the parents are used to fight, even if the parents are used to fight in front of the students, in front of their kids, at least for the last 10 days, just 10 days before the exam, avoid fighting in front of the kids. That will definitely affect their morale. That will definitely affect their confidence. Better, avoid the fight, please go out and fight, or if possible, please avoid it for the sake of the child. Also, one more thing is, I have seen many parents just blaming their children. Hey, now it's only 7 days left or 10 days left, and what you are doing is horrible. You are not even studied half of the portion. So putting pressure, blaming them, and all those things, that will drastically reduce their energy level. Instead of telling them like that, please motivate them. Say that no, it is possible for you. It is, you can make it. You can definitely get 90%. You can definitely get good marks. Like that, try to motivate them instead of degrading them, instead of demotivating them. This is very, very important, because once they become demotivated, once they lose their energy, they will not be in a position to concentrate, and ultimately the result that you are looking for will not come. The next point is, let the child meditate for at least 10 minutes, if possible, as soon as they wake up in the morning. Let the child meditate. The meditation is very, very important. Once the child meditates for 10 minutes, what happens is their mind becomes very calm. Their concentration level improves at least by 60%. That is why I am saying is, even in the beginning of the meditation, their concentration will improve by 30%. And if they continue to do for 1 week or more, their concentration will improve for more than 60%. That will definitely give a very good result. And finally, what the very, very, very important thing that they have to do, again, I am going back to the same rule of writing down what they want to achieve. Let them write down as soon as they wake up. Let them write down. Let them say loudly and write in a piece of paper or in their rough note, or in a separate handbook, I have scored 90% marks in my board exams. Specifically, if it is 10th or if it is 12th or whatever, I have scored 90% marks in the board exams. I have got so much of percentage in maths. I have got so much of percentage in science. So like that, they have to let them write it down. So once they write down, what happens is that, again, I'm coming back to the subconscious mind. Subconscious mind start working towards getting them into good marks. The universe will start working towards their success. So that itself is very, very important for them when they are going for exams. Definitely this will help them a lot. Please try it out and please keep watching the next video in which I will also talk about further ways to improve their marks and to score very good percentage in their exams. Wish you all the best, children. May God bless you all.